मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम निवेदिता सिंहदेव ऑफ मारवाड़ी कॉलेज इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक योर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर इलेक्टिव इंग्लिश दैट इज़ ऑफ 100 मार्क्स. एज इन प्रीवियस वीडियोज वी हैव स्टार्टेड द नॉवल. इन दोज वीडियोज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द वर्क and life of R.K. Narayanan. Today we will going to start the novel. Elective English fiction novel, The Financial Expert by R.K. Narayanan. Main characters are Mrigya, Dr. Paul, Mr. Madan Lal and Balu. Balu is the son of Mrigya. Dr. Paul and Mr. Madan Lal are friends of Mrigya and business partner. Part 1. People used to call him Mrigya. Nobody knew what his real name was, except his parents. He was named by the ancestral villagers after the enchanting god Krishna. Everybody thought that the name Mrigya was given to him at his naming ceremony. He had himself forgotten his name and used to sign his name Mrigya even in legal documents. Marg means the way and aya is an honorable suffix. Thus, Mrigya means the person who showed the way. Mrigya showed way out to those who were in financial troubles. Even those who lived 100 miles away from Malgudi came to him for help. The proudest building in Malgudi is the Central Cooperative Mortgage Bank. In front of the bank, there is a grassy compound. On the other side, there is a banyan tree. Mrigya runs his financial transactions under this area. In a semicircle around Mrigya sat the villagers. And by seeing their attitude and expression, one could easily guess that they were his supplicants. Mrigya was about 42. The people gave respect to his commands. Mrigya was a wizard to the villagers and he helped them in taking loans from cooperative bank. His living depends upon helping the poor people in getting loans from the cooperative bank. He carried under his arm a small grey-coloured tin box. This small box contained his entire equipments, a bottle of ink, a pen, a blotter, register, which carried assortment of names and figures. The most important item which the box carried was the loan application forms of the cooperative bank. The greatest asset in his life was the application form, and most of his time was occupied in acquiring it. He had an agency of his own which provided him application forms. When a customer came, the first question Mrigya asked, Have you secured the application form? If the answer was in negative, Mrigya asked him to go inside the bank building and bring one form and also try to bring one or two spare forms as well. It was not always possible to secure more than one form because the clerks refused to give them forms and collected fees. Mrigya managed to give them forms. Mrigya charged fees filling the details in the forms. In other cases, help of Mrigya was very much important. The clerks harassed the villagers by their own method. A villager who wanted to know his account had to ask for it at the account counter, and variably the accountant and clerks snapped back. "Where is your passbook?" A villager could not keep his hand on the passbook. If the passbook was out of sight, then it was out of date too. Thus, the villager was placed at the mercy of the clerk, who said that he was not paid for his business only. They had to pay the clerk with a cash or other kind of offerings. In such some circumstances, Mrigya's help provided invaluable. Mrigya kept accounts of at least 50 members of the bank. What its red tape obstructed the cleared up by his own effort. Most of the accounts of members of the bank were carried in his head. He had to see the customer, and he would immediately tell him if he had paid rupees of his previous loan. He could get the new loan of rupees 300 within a week. The bank bylaw allows a new loan when 50% of the old loan is paid up. Mrigya talked the villagers on those affairs which were of benefit to him. Otherwise, he would not pay heed to their questions. People in urgent need of money used to come to Mrigya. He knew how to handle them and how to make the best of profits. If someone needed money urgently for his daughter's marriage and asked for monetary help, Mrigya said, "Your daughter's marriage would be forgotten by you after I do your service. You won't need Mrigya anymore." This showed that Mrigya adopted different schemes to earn money on high rates from the customers. One day, a villager called Kannada came walking from his village 15 miles away. He owned about 20 acres of land and a house and cattle, but all of it was wasted upon in mortgages. He was a gambler and drank heavily, and he always asked for money on the pretext of having to marry his daughter, of whom he had a good number. Mrigya helped him to borrow as much as he wanted by saying, "The only course now left is for you to take a joint loan, but the difficulty will be to get a partner for it." Mrigya asked the villagers sitting by any of them could be that person's partner. The villagers shook their head in the negative. Mrigya did not want to lose the opportunity. Mrigya had to talk to privately with Malanna, a person sitting there. All the villagers pretended that they were not hearing or paying any heed to what they were talking, but all their attention was concentrated on their whispers. Mrigya said to Malanna that he was the only man who could help Kannada by helping him in taking loan. Mrigya said to Malanna that he would lose nothing but would get a little gain as interest they could pay 70% and clear half of their loan and apply for a fresh one. As they did not want a loan for themselves, they could take a loan as help for Kannada in marrying his daughter. Kannada would pay them 7.5%. They would pay only 4.5%. The result of all this talk was the Malanna agreed to the proposal Meghia grew busy filling up a loan application form with all the details of the Mallanna's heritage, etc. He read it out aloud, seized hold of Mallanna's left thumb, pressed it on a small ink pad. He carried it in his box and pressed it again on the application form and endorsed it. He took out of the box 75 rupees in cash and handed them to Mallanna and asked him to credit this to his account and then present that application form. Mrigyas worked very hard under the shade of the tree. He advanced loan and then passed on to someone in need for a higher interest, and thus his business worked. Mrigya was the center of all the complex transactions and made all the parties concerned to pay him for his services. When the evening sun hit him, he pulled down the lid of his box and locked it up, and his gathering understood that the financial wizard was closing his office for the day. Today, up to this, we will continue in our next video.